Hi, I'm Brian Wood. I'm an application engineer for BenchVue, and today we're going to talk about how to capture things in the Oscilloscope app that are not part of BenchVue using Command Expert and Test Flow. All right, so I've started BenchVue and selected a Keysight 4000 series scope. As I go from the Bench tab to the Apps tab, Data Manager, Library, you can see the various features of BenchVue. One of the things that is very useful is the Library tab. So in this demo, I'm going to be needing to get access to some of the low-level programming commands for the oscilloscope. The easiest way to find out what those are is through the manuals. So I can come over here to Manuals, I can click the Programmer's Guide, and as long as I'm connected to the internet, I will be able to get the data sheet for the oscilloscope. So I will, today we're going to be showing you how to do a mask test using the oscilloscope. And so I'm going to search for mask test. And it tells me that's in chapter 24. I can go to the introduction. And here I now see some sample code that tells me how to use that feature in the application. So now that I know what the commands are going to be and in what order I need to execute them, I can do that from BenchVue. But how do I do that? The commands are not available in the app itself. As I go look at the different tabs here, instrument settings, screen image, trace data, measurement data log, I can select channels, I can increase and decrease the vertical and horizontal resolution, I can set triggers, but I can't send low-level Skippy commands. To do that, I have to start BenchVue Test Flow. All right, and in Test Flow, if I already know the commands, I can go over to the More Blocks section, click on Advanced, and drag the Skippy block over into the Test Flow sequence. I can give it the address of the instrument, and then start typing commands, such as star IDN question mark. If I don't know those commands, I'm going to need some help. And where I get that is Command Expert. So I can drag Command Expert over into the sequence. And when I click this symbol right here, it will start Command Expert in a separate screen. And as soon as it comes up, I'll be able to create a sequence from Command Expert. So the first step is to locate your instrument, and as soon as you've found it, alright, so now I've got my oscilloscope in my instruments. I can now connect to it. And now I see a list of all the available Skippy commands. I also see some additional commands down at the bottom that are kind of more global things that allow me to change timeouts, turn on and off the error queries, and things like that. But if I want to get the mask test in particular, I will go down here to M-Test, which is what the manual told me I need to do, and I see all the available choices for the mask test. Let's just pick one. Let's say I need to enable it. Over here is, on the right is a description of the enable command. I can now add that step, and if it needs variables or it needs some special command added to it, it lets you select those. So let's turn enable on and add the step. So as you can see, it's fairly straightforward to select a Skippy command, read about it, add the step into the sequence. You can also create variables that can be exported to the add-on. When I do that, when I click export to add-on, it has now inserted that Command Expert sequence in the BenchVue Test Flow sequence. So that's all there is to that. Let me load a program that I've previously created that will do a complete mask test, and we can step through it line by line and just see what's going to happen. Okay. Here's a sequence that involves, actually calls Command Expert three times. The first time is to do the initialization. So in this sequence, I am doing an enable. That's the command I just showed you before. I can select a source channel, tell it I want divisions in for my units. I can set the X delta and the Y delta, which is the basically the difference between the nominal signal and the where you're going to define an error to occur. The create command then will actually create the mask, and we're going to give it a certain length of time. All right, so that basically just sets the thing up without actually executing anything. I did create two variables, the X delta and the Y delta, and I used test flow to define those variables. So if I look under my variables block, I can see an X delta and a Y delta that I've created. It allows me to define those at the beginning of the sequence in case I want to change it easily. All right, and then so at the end of this first command block, I've got the instrument set up to do a mask test. What I want to do then is apply a signal that's different. So I will, at that point, change the voltage intensity of the signal going in so that it will generate a failure. Then I call Command Expert again just to start the oscilloscope, so put it in run mode. So in this case, the only command in here is a run command. When I'm done with that, and I again have to wait a couple of seconds for the actual acquisition to finish, I'll call Command Expert a last time and go retrieve the waveforms that have failed. In other words, the count of the number of waveforms that have failed and the total number of waveforms that were captured. And finally, I want to actually get a screen capture of the results. So what I did here is go into the Screen Image tab and drag Get Current Screen into my test sequence, just like I'm doing here. And then at the very end, I output the number of total and the number of failed waveforms. Those will show up over in the table data on the right. So let's go ahead and execute it. When I hit run, the scope has captured the nominal waveform and applied the mask to it, which you can see on the oscilloscope itself. And what I'll do now is change the voltage and hit continue. When I do that, it's going to fail. So the test will generate a waveform that is outside the limits set by the mask test. At that point, I have captured the screen. I can double click over here in the table data, bring up the waveform that it captured, and at that point I can export it into Word or into a screenshot. And that's it. It's as simple as that.